iHeart, get ready. Fantasy football is here. Welcome to the Scout Fantasy Show. ScoutFantasy.com is home to the Fantasy Football World Championships and the best players in the world. Real money winners giving their secrets to help you win. Now exclusively on iHeart. This is the Scout Fantasy Show with your host, the one, the only, Dr. Roto.
Hey there, everybody. It's Dr. Roto. Get out the insurance cards. Get out the copay. The office is open, my friends. All right. Just want to encourage everybody to check out playffwc.com. That's playffwc.com. There is a Beat Dr. Roto draft again this Thursday night, 10 p.m. Thursday night. Where else do you want to be except drafting against me? Let's do it. I'm going to have about another three more drafts online over the course of the month of August. But this is one this week, August 2nd, 10 p.m. Play FFWC. Beat Dr. Roto. Come on in. Let's draft. And I was on a radio show this morning and somebody said, well, is it too soon to draft? No, I think this is a great time to draft. I'm not just saying that. I truly believe this. Now, look, what's the negative about drafting now? The negative about drafting now is maybe somebody gets injured. But the truth is, what if there aren't any injuries? You get so much better value today than you're going to get in September, right? Let's just say, I mean, argument's sake, I'll throw it, Donta Foreman, okay? Because I want to do a Texans preview. Well, right now, maybe you get him in round 13. Maybe people are worried about his injury. All of a sudden in September, if he looks pretty good, he's going in round 8 or 9. Where do you want the value? You get the value today. You don't get the value in September. When I go to Vegas, there's no value. There is zero value when I'm in Vegas. Being in Vegas, very rarely, and maybe I'm wrong, I'd have to talk to Scott Atkins about this. I'd want to see where the winning team comes from. I don't really believe the winning team comes from Vegas. I think the winning team comes from June, July, and August because that's when you get value. You don't get value in September. In September, you have a better idea of who's playing, but value's how you win. Get a guy in round 10 and let him give you round 4 of value. Let's turn to the Houston Texans podcast preview. So, look, a lot of guys will tell you songs and dances, but I'm telling you the truth. Tell you when I'm right, and I tell you when I'm wrong. I was the first expert anywhere last year who preached to Deshaun Watson. Book it. Fact. Check the tape on SiriusXM Fantasy Sports Radio. I was the guy who told you to pick up Deshaun Watson. And how good was he? For about 4 weeks there, folks, we were ecstatic. New England, he was good. Tennessee, he was great. Kansas City, 5 touchdowns. Cleveland, Seattle, he was off the chains. And then he gets injured. And I'm telling you, I never cry in fantasy football, but I almost cried last year. I almost cried because I thought I could have won. I could have won big, 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 big money last year because I had Deshaun Watson everywhere. Everywhere. Because I knew how good he was. Now, this year, I'm going to be honest with you. I'm a little worried. I'm not a lot worried. I'm not. But I'm a little worried. And why am I worried? The mobility. Are they going to let him run? Is he going to be afraid to move out of the pocket? See, the beauty of Deshaun Watson was not only that he has a pretty darn good arm and he's a winner, but that he could run for a few hundred yards. I mean, that was a beautiful thing. In the games last year, it was like 24, 31, 23, 67. Yeah, maybe a touchdown here, touchdown there. You're getting extra yards. There's nothing better than that. There is nothing better than that. I love running quarterbacks. I just don't know if he runs this year. If he doesn't run this year, statistically, he's probably the 7th or 8th best quarterback. If he runs, he's number 1 or 2. So I just don't know where I stand with that. I'm going to have to watch him more closely. If he looks like he's running, if he looks mobile, if he's getting out of that pocket, I will not hesitate to draft this guy. If I don't feel it in my bones, if I don't think that he's going to be running that much, I will wait on him and let somebody else have him. Because he's a good quarterback either way, but he's a great quarterback when he runs. Good is one thing, great is another. I want great. All right, at running back, I always seem to despise Lamar Miller. Maybe it's me. I know what it is. I've decided I know what it is. I think he should be better than what he is. I think he should be a star, and he's not. And he always seems to let me down. And because of that, I just tend to overlook him. He's never a big touchdown guy. He gets a lot of receptions, but not for a lot of yards for some reason. It's like the guy gets 30 receptions for 200 yards. It's just not enough. If you want to take Lamar Miller as your running back two, it makes sense, and I'll never tell you not to do it. He's just a player I tend not to draft because I want a guy who's going to be better than I think he is. Lamar Miller's never better than I think he is. He's exactly who I think he is, and that's my problem. I want a guy who's better. I may lose, but I want to draft a guy who I think can give me better numbers than what I expect. Now, I love Dante Foreman. I did. I love this dude in Texas. He ran for 2,000 yards, 15 touchdowns. Can't catch a lick, but he was good. And then he gets injured after having two touchdowns against Arizona and another. I mean, really, I felt so badly for this kid. Tears his Achilles. I think he gets placed on the PUP list and misses a few games. There's no need to rush him back. You have Lamar Miller. You have Alfred Blue. Don't bring Foreman back until he's ready. That said, if the team thinks he's ready week one, so be it. But I don't think he will be. I think he misses the first few games of the season. Is there a better receiver in football than DeAndre Hopkins? I mean, maybe it's Antonio Brown. But outside of that, he may be better than Beckham because he's not as crazy as Beckham. He's better than Julio Jones-Roto. I love this kid. I just love this kid. Now, here's something that makes Hopkins really special. Not only is he a great player, and I love the fact that he gets frustrated, but he isn't like a petulant baby like Beckham, who I love, okay? But think of it this way. Miller, good running back. Will Fuller can run. Ryan Griffin, decent enough tight end. There's just enough talent around him that Hopkins won't get double covered this year so long as Watson's in the game. When Watson's playing with Watson's mobility, Miller's ability to run, Fuller's ability to stretch the field, Griffin and Coutee's ability to be over the middle, Hopkins will get one-on-one coverage. And when he does, he's unstoppable. Unstoppable. It's one of the reasons I like Odell Beckham so much. You have Engram, you have Shepard, you have Saquon Barkley. You know Beckham's going to be good. See, I don't feel the same way about the Cincinnati Bengals. If John Ross doesn't play and Tyler Eifert's hurt, I'm putting three guys on AJ Green. I can't say that with Hopkins, which is why he's such a good pick. If you are picking 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and you take Hopkins, I have no problem with it. It's a great pick. I like Will Fuller too. He had 7 touchdowns last year, which was really shocking because this guy's had a huge case of the drops in his career. But if he's over the case of the drops, he is really fast. And once again, he benefits from playing on the other side of DeAndre Hopkins. You have to cover Hopkins. You have to watch for Watson's mobility. You have to cover Ryan Griffin over the middle. You have to cover running lanes from Lamar Miller. Will Fuller gets to run against one-on-one coverage, and he can outrun that coverage almost every time. He is a very good wide receiver 3 in fantasy football. I have no problem drafting him. I'm not big in Bruce Ellington or Braxton Miller, but I want you to keep your eye on a kid named Kiki Coutee, which is a cool name, by the way. He played at Texas Tech. Take a look at his last year numbers. Had 123 targets. This was a prolific offense. 93 receptions, 1,400 yards receiving, and 10 touchdowns. And he is a returner. This is a guy who's going to return either punts, kicks. He's got that ability. I think he's going to be the starting slot receiver. He fits that offense perfectly. Braxton Miller, not having it. Bruce Ellington, maybe my 4th or 5th receiver. But this guy, Coutee, is real deal. Hopkins, Fuller, Coutee, Miller, and Watson, we're on to something here, guys. At tight end, there's Ryan Griffin, who's very sure-handed. I like Ryan Griffin. Don't ever knock Ryan Griffin. The problem with Ryan Griffin is that he's always injured. And I really think the next major injury he has, his career could be done like CJ Fedorowicz. He is one injury away from oblivion. Steven Anderson, I don't know, maybe he just doesn't understand the playbook. He's an athlete, but he's not a great player. He's a terrible blocker. He's a marginal receiver. Look, when a team drafts 2 tight ends in rounds 3, Jordan Akins, and round 6, Jordan Thomas, it tells you they don't believe much in Steven Anderson. So it wouldn't surprise me to see Anderson be done, and Jordan Akins move up the depth chart. The Texans coaching staff coached Akins in the Senior Bowl. Went to UCF. They know what he can do, so I think he's a sneaky player there. So keep your eye on him if you're in a dynasty league. He's a little bit older, but he's a really good player. For IDP purposes, hello, J.J. Watt, Whitney Mercilus, Bernardrick McKinney, Zach Cunningham, J. Devin Clowney. I mean, this is the best front seven in football, arguably. Those linebackers are amazing. Zach Cunningham is a tackle machine. McKinney's great. Clowney and Mercilus on the outside. Whew. And J.J. Watt is a beast. I always tend to look for the Texans, right, as the third or fourth defense off the board. I always like playing them. Then they get Tyrann Mathieu. I mean, love this defense. And for IDP purposes, a lot of guys there you can choose from. Here's my only problem with the Texans this year. They're in a really tough division. You got the Jaguars. You got the Titans. You got Colts with Andrew Luck back. This is not easy peasy. I wish it were for them because I like them. And I like Bill O'Brien and I like this team. But I just wonder whether or not it's going to be look, they could go 8-8 this year and still have a good year. It's not their fault. They play some really good teams. The Jaguars and Titans, four games there, not easy. Not easy at all. But you know how we make it easy? We make it easy for you at scoutfantasysports.com. You'll find me, you find Sean Childs, you find Adam Ronis, doling out the info that you need to win your fantasy football leagues. And if you feel confident enough, and I hope you do, go to playffwc.com. That's playffwc.com right now. Get into one of our leagues. Best ball leagues, online championship leagues, fantasy football main event, whatever it is, be part of what we're doing. Best customer service, best payouts in the industry. Be with what we're doing, whether it's the Palms Hotel in Las Vegas, come to the Real World Suite and hang out with us, or whether it's online, just be drafting, playffwc.com. All right. But now it's time to put away the insurance cards, put away the copay. The office is closed, my friends. Back with so much more tomorrow. This is Dr. Roto saying be well and take care.
Thanks for listening to the Scout Fantasy Show. There's never been a better time to join the Scout Army. Visit scoutfantasy.com. Use the promo ROTO for 2 months free. And don't forget, fantasy players, please thumbs up the podcast on the iHeart app. See you next time. Go Scouts!